Please sing with me the opening hymn, number 712, The King of Love My Shepherd Is, number 712. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us call to mind our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Christe eleison.
Christe eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie
Glory to God. us pray. Almighty ever-living God, lead us to a share in the joys of heaven, so that the humble flock may reach where the brave shepherd has gone before, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Then Peter stood up with the 11, raised his voice, and proclaimed, "Let the whole house of Israel know for certain that God has made both Lord and Christ, this Jesus whom you crucified." Now when they heard this, they were cut to the heart, and they asked Peter and the other apostles, "What are we to do, my brothers?" And Peter said to them, "Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the forgiveness of your sins, and you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. For the promise is made to you and to your children and to all those far off, whomever the Lord our God will call." He testified with many other arguments and was exhorting them, "Save yourselves from this corrupt generation." Those who accepted his message were baptized, and about 3,000 persons were added that day. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. In verdant pastures he gives me repose. Beside restful waters he leads me, he refreshes my soul. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. He guides me in right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk in the dark valley, I fear no evil, for you are at my side with your rod and your staff that give me courage. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. You spread the table before me in the sight of my foes. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Only goodness and kindness follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord for years to come. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. A reading from the first letter of St. Peter. Beloved, if you are patient when you suffer for doing what is good, this is a grace before God. For to this you have been called, because Christ also suffered for you, leaving you an example that you should follow in his footsteps. He committed no sin, and no deceit was found in his mouth. When he was insulted, he returned no insult. When he suffered, he did not threaten. Instead, he handed himself over to the one who judges justly. He himself bore our sins in his body upon the cross, so that, free from sin, we might live for righteousness. By his wounds you have been healed. For you have gone astray like sheep, but you have now returned to the shepherd and guardian of your souls. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
the good shepherd, says the Lord. I know my sheep and mine know me. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said, Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever does not enter a sheepfold through the gate, but climbs over elsewhere, is a thief and a robber. But whoever enters through the gate is the shepherd of the sheep. The gatekeeper opens it for him, and the sheep hear his voice. As the shepherd calls his own sheep by name and leads them out. When he has driven out all his own, he walks ahead of them, and the sheep follow him, because they recognize his voice. But they will not follow a stranger. They will run away from him, because they do not recognize the voice of strangers. Although Jesus used this figure of speech, the Pharisees did not realize what he was trying to tell them. So Jesus said again, Amen, amen, I say to you, I am the gate for the sheep. All who came before me are thieves and robbers, but the sheep did not listen to them. I am the gate. Whoever enters through me will be saved. And I will come in and go out and find pasture. A thief comes only to steal and slaughter and destroy. I came so that they might have life and have it more abundantly. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
So I was instructed earlier this week that because today is the celebration of the Good Shepherd, that I was to speak of my vocation story and the priesthood by Father Mike Kuchar. So, it's a good topic though. So that being said, I'm not going to tell you my vocation story. I'm sure you've heard Father Mike's several times, but my vocation story is kind of long. I'm a couple years older than Father Mike, so mine extends a little bit further into the past. But I'll tell you a part of it. I'll tell you just the one little kind of. I'll tell you the end of the story anyway. After 8.5 years in the Army, I leave active duty and I go into seminary. I'm in seminary for 7 years until the day of my diaconate ordination, right? And there were some hiccups along the way, I won't lie. But on that day, as I'm about to walk into St. Meinrad's Arch Abbey Church to be ordained a deacon, this incredible sense of peace descended upon me. As I'm about to enter in through those doors, underneath the statue of Our Lady, Seat of Wisdom, with Saint Benedict and Saint Scholastica on both sides of her, I look through the doorway, through that archway, and I see the altar. I see the Saint Martyr Church altar. And this incredible sense of peace and acceptance of my vocation descended upon me. And I can tell you, it's kind of funny. After 7 years of seminary, it wasn't until that moment that I actually finally, with my whole heart, said yes to the voice of my shepherd. That was the first time that I finally gave myself over and became a sheep to the good shepherd. And my brothers and sisters, wow. I can't express to you, I can't explain to you, other than with cheap and pale words, the sense of peace that descended upon my heart. Just thinking about it right now, see the smile on my face? Yeah, it was twice as big, and I had it for a week. To the point where I still kind of, you know, some of my brother priests still very good-naturedly poke fun at me a little bit for my diaconate ordination, because the smile on my face was so permanent and huge. And from then on, that whole next year until my priesthood ordination was just one joy after another. Because I wasn't trying to follow my own path. I was following the Good Shepherd. Whose voice are you listening to? Whose voice out there are you listening to? Are you hearing? What are you being distracted by, being led by? Because if it's the Good Shepherd, then peace will just fill your heart. Now, will there be difficulties and struggles? Yeah, come on. Yes, always. But underneath all of that will be peace. I'm reminded of another point in that year after my diaconate ordination. I spent the summer at St. Mark Parish on the south side of Indianapolis, Billy Cross's home parish. So, you know, but that's actually where I met Billy back many moons ago. But the pastor there at the time was Father Todd Reeby. I hope to be like Todd Reeby one day when I grow up. He is by far and away one of my hero priests. The man is incredible. His story is incredible. His love is incredible. And I'll never forget what he told me as I was ending my summer there at St. Mark. He was imparting some of his priestly wisdom on me. And he said, I have three pieces of advice for you. Three things that you should always try and do when you're at a parish. Be kind. First and foremost, what he inspired me to do. Be kind. Look at the people that I'm trying to shepherd. And be kind. If you look at our gospel story today, right?
Jesus says, I'm the way. Follow me. I'm the good shepherd. And then the sentence at the end of the first paragraph just cracks me up. It says, the Pharisees did not realize what he was trying to tell them. The Pharisees never realized what Christ was trying to tell them, right? But here it is. They didn't realize it. So what does he do? Does he throw up his hands and storm away? Does he shout at them? Does he curse them? Not in this gospel. What does he do? He's kind. And he begins to, he tries to come at it from a different angle. So that his sheep would hear his voice. So my brothers and sisters, I ask you again, whose voice are you hearing? Whose voice are you listening to? Does it give you a sense of peace? Does it lead you to kindness? One of the great images in this gospel is the image of Christ as the gate. Not just the good shepherd, which he is, but he's not only the good shepherd who walks through the gate, he's the gate itself. He is the way, the truth, and the life. Through him, all good things enter this world. In fact, the doxology at the end of our Eucharistic prayer, what do we say? Or what does the priest say? He holds up Jesus Christ in the elements of the bread and the wine, right? He holds up the consecrated hosts, holds up the Eucharist, and he says, through him, with him, and in him. Through Christ, with Christ, and in Jesus Christ. All glory and honor are yours. In the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, our Heavenly Father. Got it a little bit wrong there, but that's okay. My brothers and sisters, whose voice are you listening to? And is it giving you a sense of peace? Is it calling you to kindness? And is it bringing you to the Eucharist? That's who the Good Shepherd is. That's who the gate is. That's who we're called to be. My brothers and sisters, we know truth when we hear it. We know the voice of our shepherd. So whose voice are you listening to? Now, let us express our faith in God in the words of the Nicene Creed. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men, for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end.
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Turning to our loving Father, let us now offer him our prayers and our petitions. For the Holy Catholic Church, for all of her shepherds, our bishops, priests, deacons, and all the lay ministers who help guide and lead our church, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our nation, for all of our political leaders, that they may hear the truth in the Good Shepherd's voice and lead and enact laws in accord with justice and with life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us gathered here and for all of our families, that we may always strive to hear the Good Shepherd's voice, to be kind, and to enter into the Eucharist. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who will go without today, whether it be some emotional need or some physical need, that God may inspire us to provide them care, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of those who have died, and for all of those who will die today, that they may enter the glory of God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all the intentions that we hold in the depths of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
we offer all of these prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please sing the offertory hymn, You Satisfy the Hungry Heart, 939, number 939.
Come give to us.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Grant, we pray, O Lord, that we may always find delight in these paschal mysteries, so that the renewal constantly at work within us may be the cause of our unending joy. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously. When Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For with the old order destroyed, a universe cast down is renewed, and integrity of life is restored to us in Christ. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people, exult in your praise. And even the heavenly powers and the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you never cease. You give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord, Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Vincent de Paul, with Saints Philip and Saint James, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope and Charles our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Kingdom of the power and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Behold, the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body of Christ come and stay for your life.
Let us pray.
Look upon your flock, kind shepherd, and be pleased to settle in eternal pastures the sheep you have redeemed by the precious blood of your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace to glorify the Lord by your lives.
Thanks be to God.
The closing hymn is number 645. There's a wideness in God's mercy, number 645.